right, hello lads, so this is my new wee camera. I said last week when I mucked up the in-car camera footage that I was going to get a new wee camera. I don't actually know if I included that in that video just because the car footage was that much of a mess last week that I didn't bother including most of what I said in. It's just a waste of time essentially. But this camera, I've been waiting so long for it to arrive and I'm hoping it's the answer to all my car content prayers. I'm hoping that this new camera, the Insta360 Go 2, is, as I said, the answer to my prayers. I'm hoping that it's fully stabilised because it's got like flow state stabilisation, something like that. You should be able to see a lot of me at the moment, including the steering wheel. You might even be able to see Jenny. Anyway, we're going to try and make a wee video out of this, just about car content. I wanted to try out this camera, as I said. It's hopefully going to be the case that, you know, we can get back to football games and we can maybe do a kind of post-match kind of chat. I will still probably always have a vlog, but I could potentially have a kind of post-match chat type thing. I'd probably need to come up with some kind of quirky, trendy name for that just to make it a bit more YouTube-y. I may or may not end up chatting about football on the way back when Jenny's been in the car. I'll see you in a minute. Right, we're back. Jenny has left the building, or the car, as we say. And yes, let's talk about a bit of football. It's looking like we're going to get a quite tasty cup double for the smaller teams in the SPFL. Now, it's a bit condescending to call them smaller teams, but in comparison to like the Celtics and Rangers of this world, they are. And it is very pleasing to see the smaller teams do so well this year, and Celtic and Rangers not have the same success that they have for a long, long time in terms of cup football in this country. It's obviously really nice for kind of provincial clubs or fans of provincial clubs like myself, Dunfermline, see that there is the opportunity there eventually for these type of clubs to actually do well. We've seen it earlier on in the season with St Johnstone winning the League Cup. Now they're one of the teams that are through into the next round after, of course, knocking out Rangers. And it's one of these things. It's like, it's part of Scottish football that it makes these competitions kind of watered down a bit when you always see Celtic winning the cup, and that has been the case for a lot of years now. And this year, I think a lot of people expected Rangers to do really well, but that's not been the case. Rangers have been knocked out twice now in the League Cup and the Scottish Cup respectively by St Mirren and St Johnstone, and clearly that St Johnstone win the other night was absolutely fantastic, and you can give no other superlatives to teams like that who go out and just absolutely deserve every bit of success that they get. And the St Mirren win as well against Rangers earlier this season was a bit of a different win on that night. I think St Mirren thoroughly deserved it and scored 3 goals in the night, which a lot of teams have struggled to do in general against Rangers this season. But in terms of that St Johnstone win, it was everything you expect a team like that to play away at Ibrox, and then to come away with a victory like they did. Obviously Xander Clark played a massive part in that, not only almost scoring but definitely assisting the equaliser, saving shots and all sorts of things during the game, and then of course in the penalty shootout saving the penalty kicks to be able to send St Johnstone through, and you love to see that. So I know it's the chance tonight for me to be watching this. As I said, you'll know the result by the time this goes out, but it's the time for Killier St Mirren to snatch it and see if they can put themselves in history and get themselves a Scottish Cup under their belt. I believe it's now Hibs, Dundee United, St Johnstone, Kilmarnock or St Mirren. Of course, one of Kilmarnock or St Mirren will now be in the semi-finals. And, you know, it's just fantastic. Get it up, Premier Sports, for only wanting, you know, the old firm ties and stuff like that in these type of games that they get on their streaming service. They got the Glasgow Derby Rangers v Celtic game in the fourth round, and then they were probably wanting Rangers to go right through to the final just for the sake of the viewing figures and stuff, and now they're going to have had two lots of semi-finals at Hampden and two lots of finals at Hampden in the League Cup and the Scottish Cup with no Rangers or Celtic representatives in either of them. It really is quite pleasing stuff. You can't really not laugh at that type of thing, because it's exactly what these mainstream media people are wanting, and Scottish football's thrown a massive curveball in it, and it's going to be one of the more provincial clubs. They're not exactly small clubs. Hibs are clearly a big club. Dundee United are a bit down for Hibs, but are still a big club in Scotland. And then you've got the likes of St Mirren and Kilmarnock and St Johnson as well fighting it out, who are probably a bit a level below Dundee United, but they're all clubs worth their merit on their day as long as they're performing on the pitch. And that's exactly what these clubs have done to get to this stage in the competition, and I just can't wait to see who goes on and lifts the trophy. If Callum Davidson can somehow manage to pull his St Johnson's side to get in a cup double this season, then I do not see a reason why he shouldn't be manager of the season, because, I mean, ultimately he'll have won more silverware than the likes of Steven Gerrard will have, and on top of that, he's done magnificently with St Johnson since the start of the season. There was at one point where they were bottom of the Premiership with 7 points, and I think 4 points adrift from 8th place, and honestly a lot of people were looking at it at that point thinking that St Johnson would have a chance of going down. Now they've secured the top 6 place, they've won the League Cup, and then in the semi-finals going to Hampden Park once again with the chance of winning the Scottish Cup as well as that. So it really is fairy tale stuff. As I said, you'll love to see it, and it's what Scottish football is all about. Anyway, that's it for this video, guys. Cheers for watching. I hope you enjoyed this card content. Hopefully it's a decent week in a chatty format, and hopefully, as I say, the rickiness wasn't as bad as it has been in the past. Hopefully this is usable footage, but if it has been and you have enjoyed it, then like the video, comment down below your thoughts on, obviously, the Scottish Cup shenanigans that I've been chatting about, and just the general feeling around Scottish football that the lesser clubs can go on and win trophies this season. Subscribe for more of this type of content, and until the next video, I'll see you then. Cheers, guys.